In the heart of North Yorkshire, the spa town of Harrogate, where this unassuming smiddy is the base for stainless steel sculptor Steve Blaylock and his specially modified vanbulance, which today he's using on a rescue mission for components he's never used before. And that means a trip to the Dark Horse Brewery, where Richard Ayton Jones is nursing unlikely artists' materials.
We have scrap all the time. We don't want it lying around. It's not doing anybody any favours, so we just want to use it. So it's really handy to have guys to come and use it for whatever they want to do.
After he arrives...
Oh, hi, Steve.
Hello, dude. How are you doing?
Steve promptly places his order.
I've come to see if you've got any scrap barrels.
I have got some casks that I was going to take to the scrapyard, okay. But if you're interested in them...
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Would you like to have a look?
Yeah, I can. Are they over here?
Yeah, these are the ones I'm getting rid of.
These look fantastic. This is exactly what I was hoping for, really.
But looks can be deceiving, and Steve needs to ensure they have the right composition.
What I'm going to do, though, just because it's me, I've brought my grinder.
Right.
I just want to just check. So you might want to stick your fingers in your ears and move to one side.
I'll get out of the way.
Yeah, because it might get a bit dangerous.
Okay.
All right.
On you go. Have a go.
All right.
As Richard wisely retreats...
Never work with gloves and beer bottles.
Steve gets set with his apparatus. If the casks are stainless steel, they'll create sparks. No pyrotechnics means aluminium. But he doesn't want to grind too much away.
It is a successful trip for a person who doesn't drink. Yes, stainless steel barrels, all that we need. And they're all 2 mil thick as well, which is perfect thickness of steel for a public sculpture.
Now the really hard work begins.
Time to get them back to the vanbulance. Not as easy as you think.
After shifting the vanbulance, Steve gets another 10 rounds in.
Come back.
And calls time on his session.
We've got more than enough to start experimenting with, really, so back into the vanbulance and back off towards Harry's.
Now Steve must give his bootload of barrels a nature theme. First job, break them open with his plasma cutter.
Something happened. It just made a quiver.
But Steve's not sure how the cask will react under such intense heat.
Hopefully it's a good sign. Here's the last bit now.
The other end is soon unsealed. But has Steve gone too far?
I've destroyed that barrel. It's a good job I've got another 10 of them, isn't it?
He perseveres with the plasma to try and peel it open, knowing the cuts could cause the cask to burst open like a coiled spring.
That's about as exciting as it gets around here. I have to try and open it out. This is going to be the interesting thing.
Next, Steve must resort to brute strength.
Flipping it.
But that won't be enough.
As one divorce lawyer said to the other, it's extra leverage. Well, as you can see, it's working a little bit. Wow. Ooh, it's just a problem that needs to be solved.
And Steve must solve it fast, because if he can't flatten the barrel, his chances of sculpting with it are virtually non-existent. It's a week later in Harrogate, and stainless steel specialist Steve Blaylock has been putting all his energies into flattening out scrapped beer casks.
Nothing's ever easy.
Almost to his downfall.
I'd love to be able to say he's one I made earlier, but I can't.
Forced to change tactic to cut shapes from the casks first.
That's what it looks like when it's cut from the barrel.
Marathon sessions with various mallets and hammers have eventually bludgeoned the smaller sections into giant petals.
So that's better. It's almost flat.
And a plan has come to fruition.
I've got a commission for Fountains Abbey in Yorkshire to make six large flowers for their sculpture trail, which opens in the spring.
Now he has another dilemma.
I was trying to figure out last night how to make a representation of the stamens, I think they're called, on the flower. And it was about 11 o'clock, and I was ready to eat the flower. And then I thought I could use those.
Steve's collection of measuring spoons proves very handy.
Right. One.
But he'll have to repeat this procedure hundreds of times.
A lot of what you do with the sculptures, people only see the finished thing. And some of it has got so much work in it, I could probably stop halfway through making it and nobody would ever know.
And Steve's adamant to impress his new commissioners.
And Fountains Abbey has got an amazing history. Obviously, inhabited by monks, they used to own most of the area. And I guess they only made beer as well at some point, which is quite good because that's what these are made from, beer barrels. So, kind of what goes around comes around, I guess.
As his spoon stamens are set in position, as after a few last tweaks, Commissioner Nina Kingham and brewer Richard Ayton-Jones arrive for the reveal.
Hello.
Steve's understandably anxious.
So, you've not seen any sketches? You've not seen work in progress? And so this might not be what you want. I guess now I should unveil it and see what you think.
Yes, please.
Yeah?
But he can't put it off any longer.
Amazing.
Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness.
That is incredible.
Wow.
Nina has no idea what her flower's made of.
So, that is it one of them?
Wow.
These were just old casks that we didn't have any more use for anymore. Mm-hmm. But Steve has managed to create something absolutely amazing out of them. You've literally used the whole barrel to make this, haven't you?
Yeah, literally the whole barrel. And to be honest, I had no idea how it was going to turn out either.
I love the texture as well, because I think it gives them that almost larger-than-life quality. It makes them feel quite real. Really curious about this centre and how that was made and what it's made of.
These are made from measuring spoons for cooking.
Nina's impressed, but it's just the beginning.
Especially now I've seen this one, I'm really excited to see the other five flowers that you'll be making for us.
So there's no time like the present to get on with it.
Bye then. Doors that way. Get lost, go on. I've got stuff to do.
A few days later, Steve delivered his first flower to the site at Fountains Abbey. The first element in a unique nature trail, which has already started to capture the imagination of visitors.